So basically I was about to do another video on Silverblue again, but instead I will do that first and I will upload the original right after. So, I will open Box's emulator, and here you can see the Silverblue image I'm using. It is a February 28th image, with Fedora 32 beta freeze been at February 25th, so I guess what you will see is going to be the final, or at least something very close to the final release. For start we have a new startup sound for Fedora 32. Take a listen.
Who in their right mind would frost a cake with their butt? Oh god, I'm going blind! Feels so good!
Okay, what was happening on the previous versions of Silverblue? Just a second to open a terminal first. So, on the initial Silverblue versions and I think till Silverblue 31, we had a very basic image with only a few core apps, like terminal and files. From that point on, we had to manually install everything else from GNOME software. What changed is that we now finally get some Flatpak apps pre-installed. And notice the Fedora runtime, which is something I do not like. But it is IBM after all, so we can't expect the best, can we? For example, Clear Linux and Intel are using FlatHub directly. And that's why I'm going to buy an AMD Threadripper. Point? Everyone sucks one way or another. For fuck's sake, create a GNOME OS. Anyway, so the pre-installed apps are disks, calculator, calendar, characters, contacts, events, logs, maps, screenshot, weather, clocks, image viewer, fonts and a text editor. And because you say I blame snaps all the time? Good luck to Ubuntu to compete that! Ha! Meanwhile, thank you very much for telling me I'm using Fedora because I didn't know it. But what I really like for Silverblue is to get their own unique branding. It may be Fedora in a sense, and even sharing packages and releases, but it is also a quite different operating system.